brought one from the outside stall. Ready?
Fire!
Racing, no surrender, jump well inside it. I hope you dance from the inside. Vicinity and At War was away much better. Vicinity, Blazing Passion behind those, settling down. Lasting Impact being followed by Skillful Hunter, who's pushing up near the rail. And dropping back, Testing Love. Also back there as well when they settle properly is Fryer the Gun. Last of all is Speed Dream. At the 800, no surrender, steadied them up. And led three quarters on At War, who's much handier. Over on the inside, running third, I hope you dance. Blazing Passion. Passion's up there running fourth. Off its heels, Vicinity on the outside of Skillful Hunter. 550 from home. Ridden along behind those, Lasting Impact. Further back then came Start the Fryer, followed further back on the outside then by the favourite, Testing Love. And last of all is Speed Dream as they come towards the home corner. 350 to go and No Surrender had pinched a handy lead. They balanced up. No Surrender shot two clear of At War, I Hope You Dance. Followed by Blazing Passion, then Vicinity. No Surrender at the 200 is the leader, but here comes At War. At War pegging ground back off. No Surrender. No Surrender finding, though, digging in hard. At War's come to the end of his run. Testing Love is jumping out of the ground late, but No Surrender will lead all the way. No Surrender beat Testing Love. At War third ahead of Vicinity. Speed Dream, Lasting Impact. Followed back behind them, I Hope You Dance, Blazing Passion, then Fryer the Gun, and the last of them home, Skillful Hunter. Number four has led all the way, No Surrender. Written by Mitchell Pateman. Number four, Testing Love, charging down the outside late, finding the 1200 a little short from her gate to grab second. At War peaking on its run, and back there in fourth place will be Vicinity. Number four, No Surrender. The Darren McAuliffe trained three-year-old by Universal Ruler from Dark Attack, ridden by Mitchell Pateman, wins 370 and 140, 10 Testing Love second by Ifraj, Grant and Alana Williams, Chris Parnham aboard, $1.50, and third placing to At War by War Chant from Dancing Pogo. Jared Noski, the rider for Trevor Andrews, will pay $1.80. So jump quickly and controlled, 1:14.07 was the time, 36:61 with this give in the track this afternoon, and the margins are one length and a neck. No Surrender celebrating its first victory and its seventh start after two successive placings most recently. Four first, second is number 10, Testing Love. She certainly got to the line well late, and At War, who raced much handier this afternoon, battled on after weakening over the final 100. The next on the card, the running of the Crown Perth Handicap over the 1,800 metres, and there are no changes out of the next. Well, Scott Embry is with us, and he's now with winning trainer Darren McAuliffe as they join up after this maiden victory in race number three, Scotty.
They certainly do. 4:10, 1:07 winner, No Surrender, trained by Darren McAuliffe, who joins me now. Darren, a mile back to 1,200 metres. Thought process?
I just didn't think he got a mile, really. A little bit disappointed with his last start performance. He gets on the wrong leg, and he's got no idea, this horse, and he's a difficult animal to deal with. But I just thought it was a better option than going forward with him.
Right from his two-year-old days, he's always showed his fair level of ability, though.
Yeah, he's always been above average, but he unfortunately his attitude doesn't measure up with his ability. He's a very, very difficult horse to deal with. You know, he's out the back there with a muzzle on. He'll take chunks out of everyone that walks past. He's a mongrel. But anyway, he got the job done there today, so that's good.
Is he the kind of horse where a break and another campaign's going to help, or he's always going to be like that?
No, I think we're fighting a losing battle with him. You know, he's just got a different mindset. It's weird because the whole family, they've all been the loveliest, quietest horses. But for whatever reason, he's just, he's got an attitude problem like his trainer.
Certainly does. Salaya later on. What are your expectations for the Burgess Queen?
Yeah, couldn't be happy with her. We'll see.
Couldn't be happy with the price either, probably.
Yeah, I think she's well and truly above the odds. But anyway, well, you can't eat value.
No, you can't. Hopefully we can get something on the plate later on. Well done, D-Mac.
Thanks, mate.
There's Darren McAuliffe with No Surrender here. 4-10-1-7. Number 10, testing love on debut. Really good effort late down the outside, hitting the line powerfully. At Warloom, the winner, top of the home straight, couldn't go on with it. And then fourth there was number 7 in next best. And that was Vicinity, actually. A really nice run, Neville Parnham's filly, because I think she was 70-1. She's finished off quite nicely under Bo Edwards into fourth placing. 4-10-1-7. Mitchell Pateman is the winning rider, and he's about to weigh in. And once he does, he'll catch up with Michael Heaton for a word. No Surrender wins race number 3.
Well, we saw No Surrender. He couldn't even come into the winner's stall here. Mitch, Steemac just saying that he has a few quirks. How was his behaviour today?
No, he wasn't too bad. It's good when the only instruction is get him on the right leg around the corner, and that's all I've been practising lately. So we got that right, and yeah, that's probably went a long way to him winning.
That dressage and show jumping work coming to the fore there. You looked like you were pretty keen to get to the front. You just wanted to ride him like the best horse in the race and really get rolling from the 600?
Yeah, I sort of thought mile back to 12. I had to ride him pretty positive. So, you know, his horses will be fit. So that's half the battle.
Passeran and Ruby Jean in the next race. It looks as though you've chosen Ruby Jean there. What's your expectations?
Probably not a lot between them. Family owns Ruby Jean, so that's where the loyalties lie.
I've got to keep them happy then. Congratulations.
Cheers, mate.
Certainly does there. Mitchell Pateman's family down in Albany, all in the ownership of number 7, Ruby Jean, in race number 4 here out of Ascot. But the results in race 3, Mrs. Max Maiden, it's 4-10-1-7.